दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट कंपेरिजन बिटवीन एंसिस प्लेन एंड ओपन फॉर्म यूजिंग फ्लो थ्रू एल्बो. एंसिस प्लेन एंड ओपन फॉर्म आर टू मोस्ट पॉपुलर फाइनाइट वॉल्यूम सीएफडी सॉल्वर. एंसिस प्लेन इज अ कमर्शियल सीएफडी सॉल्वर एंड ओपन फॉर्म इज अ ओपन सोर्स CFD solver. In this presentation, there are two problems: 2D flow through elbow, and second is flow through threading elbow. Elbow has a lot of application. In this problem, there are two inlet and one outlet. Laminar flow through elbow will be analyzed based on .mss file in both ANSYS plane and open form. In a 2D problem, mesh is already available. Assume that mesh is already generated and we have to solve using ANSYS plane and open form. For 2D case, we are using tate element. There is a one inlet on left side which has velocity in x direction, and it has outlet which is moving in y direction. There is also another inlet at the bottom of the elbow. Mass of elbow is defined as no slip. This is a very simple problem. We are going to understand how problem is solved in planned as well as in open form. What is the comparison in solver setting? In planned we are using GUI. In open form we are using without GUI. That we are going to understand for any beginner who want to work in open form. He has to understand how to set boundary condition without GUI, and this tutorial will help how to set boundary condition using open form with a knowledge of Fluent. Before going to simulation, we have to understand governing equation for two-dimensional laminar flow. Here flow is incompressible flow, and it in conservation of mass equation there is no variation of density with respect to time. This is a 2D flow, and there are only two part in conservation of mass equation. For momentum, there is a two equation in x momentum and y momentum. On left side, first term represent unsteady term, second term represent advection term. On the right hand side, the last term represent viscous term, and the first term on the right side present pressure gradient term. The difference between ANSYS plane and open form, there is only difference in the selection of the discretization scheme for each term in nearest equation. That we'll understand using this tutorial. First we see boundary condition in open form. Fluent is easy. Just we have to define inlet by giving component of velocity, and pressure is defined either pressure outlet or vent outlet. Valve is no slip. But in open form, the boundary condition is represented, which is shown here with one table. Boundary condition for inlet 1, we are fixing the value of velocity in x direction. Hence, velocity here is 1. You have to note here velocity is 1. For the pressure, we are fixing 0 gradient. Similarly, for inlet 2, we are giving fixed velocity in y direction, that is 3 meter per second. For the pressure is 0 gradient. For the valve, we are using no slip condition and pressure it is a 0 gradient. For the pressure outlet in open form, we have to define 0 gradient for velocity because we have taken the outlet such a way that there is a 0 gradient after development of the boundary layer or velocity profile in y direction. For the pressure, we are fixing the fixed value of 0 gauge pressure. These are the boundary conditions for the 2D problem using open form. We have to select the same solver either for 2D or 3D. If you want to solve for 2D problem, you have to give front to back surfaces to be empty. And this is empty boundary condition is given for all the variable pressure, velocity, it may be temperature. And that is the difference. For the plane, we have to select the solver either 2D or 3D, that we will discuss in this lecture. For 3D problem, boundary condition in open form is similar to this, only there is no boundary condition like front to back, because here all boundary condition inlet 1, inlet 2, which are given to the surface instead of the edge in 2D flow. Only this part is not there, like empty. The problem is similar to the 2D flow. We solve part 1 of which comprises two problems, 2D elbow problem or 3D elbow problem. We are using CFD solver ANSYS Fluent, which is a popular finite volume solver for academia and industry that we are going to discuss in this lecture. Then first we see in part 1 we discuss how to set up elbow problem using ANSYS Fluent. For using ANSYS Fluent, which is a popular finite volume solver, first open the Fluent launcher. There are three options: machine, solution, in solution I'm selecting 2D, double precision, and display mesh after reading. I give file path here for elbow problem, select it. Here option is a pre and post. I'm using solver. Yes, you don't need to click pre or post only. Then start. Then the remove this notification key behavior changes. Click remove it. File, read mesh file. Here is a elbow file. This is a 2D problem. First, we have to check information size. It has 918 cell. Check the mesh quality. Fluent mesh quality. It has quality is a 0.55. Is mesh quality is okay? First, go to for general setting. Here you can select study solver or transient solver. You can select any one if you want to solve it. Taking as a transient, or here for to compare with OpenFOAM, because OpenFOAM I am using in compressible stress state problem. Then problem is planar and pressure based solver, because pressure based is incompressible solver. Then go to the model. In model, I'm using a laminar flow as a viscous model. Then material. Here I'm using air only. Air has a density 1.1225 and viscosity 1.78 into 10 to the power minus 5. Go to sail zone, fluid, select air for the fluid zone, apply, close it, then go to boundary condition, select zone type. This is the inlet one, this is the inlet one is there. We can name as the inlet one and give velocity as 1. We can give component wise velocity as x component velocity 1, y component velocity is giving 0. Similarly, this is 1. You can check whether what is the inlet 1 and inlet 2. This is inlet, this is the second inlet. Here you can give y inlet 2. Here you can define component. Y component you can give as a 3 meter per second. Apply. Close. And pressure outlet, I am giving pressure outlet with a 0 gauge pressure. And pressure outlet I named as a pressure outlet 1. Apply. And for the valve, I am using the stationary valve no slip boundary condition. This is the no slip boundary condition, which is similar to OpenFOAM. Apply, close. Next is a method, is a simple algorithm or simplex or piezo. You can use any solver if you want. Then go to control. You can keep relaxation factor as it is. And method, I'm using the gradient is a least square cell base, pressure second base, and momentum second order. And then calculation activity, I'll save this file at 100 timestamp and auto save. I'm keeping at one file, and that means I can keep 5 data file maximum. Okay, then go to run calculation. Because going to run calculation, you have to fix the restarted value, that will be 10 to minus 6 for the all the variable. There are only variable x, y, z. Velocity, sorry, only xy velocity. Then go to run calculation. Then we select number of time step to be 1000 and individual time step to be 1 1. into 10 power minus 3. Then here calculate. Then go to the calculate here. First it will then before running you have to initialize. Then run it. See here simulation is running and his convergence is also better. I stop it. And then see contour XYZ velocity. See, this is the contour color map option. I am taking here float. This velocity I have given, maximum velocity is the 12. We can change the range as a 3 meter per second. We can take 10, it is to be more. This way we can see the contour using the axis plane and then save case data file axis elbow 2D and time step 0.012. This way we can save case data file for the 2D problem. I want to solve similar problem using 3D coordinate system. Then how we'll solve? Just close it because we have opened in the 2D platform. Then go to the client launching pad and after opening ISF Fluent launcher, select here 3D and select number of process 1, then start. Then close notification, some key behavior changes. After it, then read fluent mesh file, that 3D elbow. This is a 3D elbow and we see the how is the mesh is there. Display, all edges, see. It has a tate mesh is there. Then we check size. It has 1,26,000 cell size. And we check quality. Quality is a 0.157. Then we check convert into the poly. Then we check mesh size. Mesh size has been reduced to the around 24,000. See how mesh size is reduced by this from 1,26,000 to 24,000. That means 1/5 cell size is reduced by converting to the poly. Then we see how mesh is looking. See, this is looking as a poly mesh. Close it. Then check mesh quality. Is mesh quality is 0.412. That means mesh quality is has been improved. That means it is good for the convergence. There may be some shortcoming near the wall because poly had reduces the mesh size and resolution you may not get. But this is important. We are interested only the flow. Then we can use 3D polyhedral element. Then we see basic solver setting. Click on general. Select pressure based solver and transient. And go to the here model. Select energy. We are not going to for energy in viscous. Select laminar. Okay. And then go to the material. Click here. Select air as it is. Go to cell zone. We have selected a fluid for the air. We have selected a fluid to be air. Apply. Close it. Then go to boundary condition panel. Here inlet is one. Define boundary condition. Normal to component. Give X component as one. Apply. Then for the inlet two here. Define component. Give Y component as through be 3, because Y component is only this direction. Apply, close it. X component is already defined in X direction to be 1. Outlet to be pressure outlet with 0 gauge pressure. For the wall, it to be no slip. Next step is method selecting as a piezo. Second order for the pressure, momentum to be the second order, and gradient, that is diffusion term, it discretized using least square of cell base. Control. I keeping reluctance fraction as it is. Next is selecting the then say monitor the residual set here 10 to the power minus 6 for the continuity, same for X velocity, Y velocity, Z velocity. Then OK. Then it is set. Then go for the initialization. Initialize as it is. Again go to calculation activity. Say file at each 100 iteration. Maximum you can return 5. Then OK. Then click for run calculation. For number of iteration give 1000. Time step view as a 0.01. Time step is the here time step is the 10 final steam. That means in this case but in this case flow time will be is equal to number of time step. Into to flow time. Sorry, it is a time step. Please remember amount you have to run this simulation, and make sure that time step and number of time steps should be selected properly. If you have, for in this case I have selected number of time step to be 1000 number of, and time step is 0.001. That means is equal to 1 second. That means 1 second is the total flow time. If everything is set, then go for the calculation. click here. After clicking, we see the residual of x, y, z velocity, and here is the iteration for each time step. Number of iteration is 20. That means it run for the 20 iteration. If running is a continuous, maximum 20 iteration for each time step, and we have also defined residual for the x, y velocity, and for also same for the continuity, and summation will be going on till total number of iteration are completed, and here show the number of iteration to be left 99. That means 10 time step are completed and 990 time step are left. Summation will be going on. Here I will stop for the intermediate time step. Then I see velocity. They see, we can see also pressure also. But I want to find out the plane. Here, go to result, create as a surface mesh. I want to plane normal to the Z. This I am taking as a center. X mid, great. Then see the contour in X Z plane. In view of the light, they see the contour. Here flow is similar to the 2D, but 2D it is a like a slot problem, but it is a pipe problem. Yes, we see the more velocity here. We can also draw the wire framework. We can keep only outline. Go to the color map. Color map in raw mesh color, we can select the wall to be the dark gray. Close, and they see. You see, this is the velocity in central plane. This is the inlet, this is the outlet. In same plane, we can also take pressure, give name region for pressure, they save. They see similar for the velocity. Velocity in XY plane, take wireframe. And you select the velocity. And here see velocity. Velocity is high in this direction and less at the inlet 1. Because of mixing, velocity is increased here. Similarly, we can also see the streamline starting from inlet and outlet and give the velocity magnitude. Keep a range 0 to 30 and keep a draw mesh to be on. This way you can see the streamline of the velocity. Maximum velocity I can keep 10, we are not able to see. We can keep as a 3. Then we see these are the streamline. This way we can post-process. This is the first part, how to solve problem using the axis plane. In next part we see how to solve same problem using the open form. Thank you for attending this lecture. For more information about CFD analysis of any problem using axis plane and open form, you can visit website www.cfdflowengineering. It covers most of important topic for engineers, scientists related to the CFD and flow engineering, and also covers topic for flow technology. Thank you for attending this lecture. God bless you.